We all know that art is a very crowded place. There's lots of people who want to be artists. What you're gonna need to do to succeed in this very crowded space is you need to have your own style. You need to have something that's recognisably you. It's like a little piece of your soul that you can show people and you can say, this is me. I recently had an email from Cassie, a young up and coming artist on the Sunshine Coast, and she asked me if I could help her and give her some advice towards her journey of becoming an artist. Cassie had been trying out a whole bunch of different ideas. She would jump from one thing to the other. She would sort of jump into board art if she thought that was going to be popular, or into sculpture if that seemed like it was going to be popular. And when it didn't work, she'd just give up and move on to the next thing. She'd become really disillusioned and she wasn't having much fun making art anymore, because every time she was making something, she was always trying to keep in mind who's it for, who's going to buy it, and will it make me successful. She'd imagined from watching my videos that I had always known what I was doing, that I'd pretty much planned my whole career, but the truth is actually that her story was really, really similar to mine. Probably like a lot of you guys, I'd assumed I was going to be an artist my whole life because I've always been good at drawing. And as a kid, I totally thought that I was going to be an equine artist and paint horses for a living. And unsurprisingly, that's not actually a very viable career. So when I finished school, I went to Sydney for a few years and I studied graphic design. 5 years after that, I was in London and I was working as a designer, and I had this awesome idea that I was going to buy secondhand clothing and customize it and make little cool custom patches, you know, and paint things on them. And I was gonna make my own jewellery. And then when that didn't get off the ground, I went back to graphic design. A couple of years after that, I started doing funny ink drawings of chickens and cows with like silly sayings, and I decided I would send them to a greeting card company because they would make great cards. So after I got turned down by the greeting card companies, I went back to design. So I was a designer for 10 years, and over that time I just gradually gave up on my dream of being an artist because I didn't even know where to start. What would I do? What would I sell? How would I make a living? It was just impossible, and no one would take me seriously because all my stuff was all over the show. After I'd given up, I took up surfing because I live near some beautiful beaches, and I was really frustrated in my job as a designer. About 6 months into it, I bought myself a new surfboard and I decided to paint it because, you know, after all, I was someone who used to dabble in art. And I filmed me painting the board, the very first board, and I put it on YouTube. And that was the moment that Fieldey, the artist, was born. I'll go a bit deeper in upcoming episodes about how I took it from just like painting a surfboard to making it into a career. But suffice to say, I never started out thinking I was gonna be a surfboard artist. Like, if you told like little me that, I would've just laughed in your face because like I could barely even swim. The surfboards were the magic element that I needed. They gave me a set of limitations to work within. So the actual shape of the surfboard, so very, very long and skinny, was a limitation that I could work within. And the style that I chose, which was old school tattoo, because at the time I'd come from a drawing background and I couldn't paint. So it was easy for me to put nice big thick outlines on everything to hide the bad painting underneath. To add to that, I injected the magic X element, which was just moi, just my bad sense of humor, with a lot of puns and some pretty weird stuff, actually. The canvas, i.e. surfboards, was unusual, but the style, which is that old school tattoo style, was very well known. And combining the two right there, that was my niche. My niche was old school tattoo painted surfboards. My advice to Cassie was to just stop what she was doing and just dial it right back. She needed to get back to the art making that brought her joy. I advised her to spend the next 6 months drawing every day, to explore the things that interest her, and just to practice getting basic skills down pat. Once she found her own set of limitations, it would be time for her to refine her style and become the best painter or drawer or sculptor of those specific limitations around. She needed to be the best person doing that thing. As an artist, you know, pretty much anything can be your inspiration. It's your job to have your blinkers off and to be open for whatever comes your way, because it might just totally come at you from left field. Like, like me, like surfing. So what about you guys? What do you guys reckon? If you're already on your creative journey, how did you find your style, and what sort of tips would you give to people who were just up and coming? If you're an up and coming artist and you have more questions for me or anything you'd like to know, please ask them below. Otherwise, please subscribe to this channel if you haven't already, because that will allow me to keep making more wonderful videos. And I'll see you the week after next with an awesome Mad Skills Masterclass.